sorry because of the space constraint, but we can all huddle together in this cool cold evening. Today our lecture is going to be about why can't I see God. So before I start the talk, I'm going to offer obeisances and respects to the teachers who have taught this science to us and to Krishna. So, why can't I see God? Or the other question which is related to this or in the same line is, where is God? Right? So, this question, where is God, seems to be like a very common question but asked very uncommonly. It's not asked very frequently. Like everyone at some point, they think, where is God? Right? And but then there is some hesitation to ask this question. What if God is watching and what he gets upset? Or like the person who I ask gets upset. If I go to the temple and ask the pujari where is God, he might get upset. You know, and God himself may get upset. That immediately we feel like we are correcting ourselves. No, 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 we shouldn't ask such questions. Where is God, or why can't I see God? So there is, it's not illogical for us to think like that, because remember there was one person who asked, where is Vishnu? Remember any of you who this person is? Someone's, yes? Hiranyakashipu, very good. What's your name? Kirtana. So like Kirtana said, Hiranyakashipu asked that question, right? And what happened to him? Do you remember when he asked the question, what happened to Hiranyakashipu? Vishnu came and killed him very ghastly. So when we are trying to ask this question, we are worried, and that worry is completely, it's not baseless. So we do have some fear. But then we also see that there is another person who asked this question, where is God? This question or this questioning nature in our philosophy is called as jignasa, any kind of inquisitiveness. There is no equivalent word in English, but it is called jignasa, like the curiosity, inquisitiveness. So there was another person who asked that question too. Do you remember, does anyone know this story? There was like two brothers, and he wanted to sit in the lap of his father. Yes. Who is it? Dhruv. Yeah,
very good.
Yeah. So he also asked the question, right? He was also looking for God. Where is God? And then he went to Narad Muni and he asked, where is God? And then, but his encounter with Krishna, Vishnu, was completely a different one when compared to Hiranyakashipu. So, what is the difference between those two? What was the difference? Can anyone tell? Okay, Kirtana? So, Hiranyakashipu wanted for bad reason. He was challenging. He was saying, where is God? Show me. Oh, you think God is here? Show me, like that. And Dhruva, that boy's name is Dhruva, he had the jignasa or the inquisitive nature, and he asked because he wanted to know God. So the question itself is not wrong. So asking, where is God, is not wrong. It's the mood with which we ask. Inquisitive questioning is what we need. It's not the challenging nature. Oh, you think God can save you? Where is your God? You know, those kind of attitude is what is not recommended. So, generally in any religion, when you see, questioning is not, encouraged. Like if you go to any kind of traditional religions like Islam or Christian or anywhere, if you question, so why is it like that? So why is this? Then they say, you're committing offense. Right? But we are very lucky because our whole Vedic system is based on questioning. You remember this incident? Who this person is?
Arjuna.
Arjuna. And then the conversation between Arjuna and Krishna was which book? Bhagavad Gita. So in Bhagavad Gita, what is Arjuna doing? He's just listening to Krishna, or what is he doing continuously? He's asking Krishna all kinds of questions. Like, Krishna is answering, then he's again asking, Krishna is answering. So this questioning nature or the inquisitiveness is very much encouraged, and it is like the basis of our philosophy. So we are actually very fortunate. And not only the Bhagavad Gita, entire Srimad Bhagavatam, which is the Mahapurana, it is completely based on a conversation between Parikshit Maharaj and Sukadeva Goswami. And this is also question and answer. Like Parikshit Maharaj is asking questions about God and Sukadeva Goswami is asking, telling the answers. So when the questioning nature or the questioning inquisitiveness is very much encouraged. And the same thing, the whole Bhagavatam starts with question and answers of all the munis in Naimisharanya. So our whole philosophy is based on question and answers. So when we have this question, where is God, there is also answer by Krishna himself. God himself gives us the answer. So the answer is, Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita in 10th chapter, 8th verse. In 10th chapter actually, there are 4 verses which form the summary of Bhagavad Gita. They are called as Chatushloka Bhagavad Gita, which is the 8, 9, 10 and 11. So in that Krishna says who he is, who the devotees are and how he interacts with devotees. Just in all the 4 verses summarize everything. So among them the first verse is how Krishna describes himself. Aham sarvasya prabhavo matta sarvam pravartate iti matva bhajante mam bhuta bhava samanvitaha. So he says, I am the source of all spiritual and material worlds. Everything emanates from me. The wise who perfectly know this engage in my devotional service and worship me with all their hearts. So he is telling that everything comes from him. Everything is coming from him. And in another verse, in Brahma Samhita, he says, I am everything. I am in everything. So he says, Eko pyasaura chaitum jagadanda koti yachattirasti jagadanda chayayadanta andantarasta paramanu chayantarastam govindamadi purusham tamaham bhajami. So in this verse, andantarasta paramanu chayantarastam. So he says, he is present everywhere. Inside the atoms and even in between the atoms. So when we summarize this, he's saying, I am source of everything and I am in everything. So when you ask someone, are you going to be at home 6 o'clock tonight? Then he says, I'm going to be outside the house, I'm going to be inside the house. So you seem like they really don't want to tell you where they are, right? So it seems impossible, like, okay, this person may be not wanting to tell me where he is. So this is how it sounds like. Krishna is saying, I'm source of everything, but I'm also in everything. I'm present in between the atoms. I'm present inside the atoms. But his answer is actually pretty straightforward. So first thing he's saying, I'm source of everything, right? So this is the meaning of I am source of everything. So Krishna expands himself as Mahavishnu. This is Mahavishnu who is lying down on an ocean called as Karana Ocean. And he is breathing in and out universes. That's how universes form. They come out of, when he takes a breath, the universes come out. You see all these balls, they're all each universe. So this is Mahavishnu. So he is the source of everything. Now from Mahavishnu all the universes are coming, right? You see all these little balls each universe, and inside each universe again he becomes Garbhodaka Shai Vishnu. So that is, this is where he has Lakshmi pressing his feet. Then from his navel, Brahma comes and he does all the creation in each universe. Now after all the all the creation is done, then he comes in as Paramatma in each living entity. In every living entity, in every jiva, he is present as Paramatma. And then what about the non-living entities? Even in the atoms, molecules, and in non-living entities also, he is present as Paramatma. So after knowing all this, so from here we know that right, everything is coming from him. He is the source of everything, and also he is in everything. So where is God or where is Krishna? Is where? Everywhere. So why can't we see Krishna? He is everywhere, right? So he must be in this table, he must be in the floor, he must be in Vandya, he must be in Sevya. So why can't I see him? So for this also he has an answer. So for this I have a little exercise for the kids. So I have like, we can form like 7 teams. You can maybe just group as 7 things. This is for you. Let's see. So each have some beads and thread. And for Aditya, Rahul, Kirtan, you have this special cup. Where there is no thread. Okay? Okay, another team. You can, you and Shivali, how about Shivali, you can come closer, make him come in front. There you go. You can give behind to Rishi. Okay, you want one? Okay, there. Who else wants? There. Who else wants one? You want one? Okay. So I want you all to make a nice necklace with the beads and the thread that you have.
Exactly.
You don't get a thread.
Actually, I'm going to make you make it. So that Shivali can join you. Okay, come Shivali. Neha, get Shivali also. Okay. Okay, so are you starting to make the necklace? So maybe one. Shivali, hold one end so she can put the beads real fast. Okay, one person can hold one end and the other person can put the beads fast. Okay. So, you have to try to get them. Okay. One more minute, that's all. Yeah, one person hold the thread so it doesn't slip, okay? That is so interesting. You also have a good idea.
I'm going to ask you.
whatever, how much ever you have, that's enough. How much ever you have, that's enough. Okay? Let's see. You're done? Okay, let's see. Okay, so this is the necklace you made, right? So everyone has their necklace. They can knot this necklace and then hold it. This is the necklace for a tiny doll. You have, everyone has the necklace?
Nope.
Okay. Okay, now turn around. We are ready to do the continue the presentation. Okay? Okay, everyone pay attention. So Krishna is saying, where is Krishna? And where is Krishna? What did we think Krishna is? Where is Krishna? Everywhere. He is everywhere. So why can't we see him? He is telling in the verse, in the Bhagavad Gita 7th chapter, 7th verse, he is telling, describing why we cannot see him. So this verse goes, Matta parataram nane kinchit asti dananjaya mai sarvamidam proktam sutre maniganeva. So he is saying to Arjuna, who is called, also called as Dananjaya, everything rests upon me as pearls are strung on a thread. So you all strung pearls, right? Or yeah, the beads on the thread? Okay. So so the beads, you have strung the beads, and now how are the beads? They're nicely supported and they're staying very nicely, right?
Yeah.
There was your team didn't have the thread, right? So what, where are your pearls? They're all scattered everywhere. So the team who didn't have the threads, everything is scattered everywhere, right? Everything is scattered. But who had the thread, they could make a nice necklace. So I see in this necklace only beads. Where is the thread? I don't see. There you go. This is another. We can also use from this also. So if I see the necklace part of it, where is the thread? I don't see the thread. Do you see the thread?
Yes.
Okay. Okay. In this necklace, show me in this necklace.
It's inside,
right? So how do we know that it is inside? Inside the pearls. They are staying together and they are in balance. So, in the same way, Krishna is the one who supports everything. Okay, everyone pay attention. The bigger kids, don't distract this one. Turn around. So, what we saw, that the thread is there, but you cannot see the thread. It is, what is it doing? It is supporting everything, all the beads. So Krishna is like that. He is in everything and he is supporting everything, and then but he is not seen because he is supporting everything. So that is why the thread is not seen here. So what happens if you remove the thread? Right? So everything will be chaos. If you remove God, if you remove Krishna, everything is chaos. So when we are looking at, when we are trying to find Krishna, when we are trying to find God, what are we doing? We are just looking at the beads. We are looking at the pearls. Where is Krishna? Where is Krishna? We are looking into like science. We are looking into history. We are looking into medicine and we are thinking, where is Krishna? Where is Krishna? But we are not seeing what is the thing that is holding everything. Right? We are not looking in between these things. That is why we are not able to see Krishna. So, what is thread without the beads? If there is thread only without the pearls, is it pretty? Like that with gaps?
No.
Is it pretty? No. So, Krishna also, he doesn't want to be by himself. He wants all his jivas, all his devotees with him. So when you see this picture, Krishna is always with someone, either with a parent.